Hello, my name is Jana van Opstal. I'm a senior water productivity expert at Future Water. And in this video, I would like to talk to you about a program that we're doing called REWAS. It stands for Real Water Savings in Agricultural Systems. This is a program that was initiated with Future Water and FAO. And in this video, I'll go through with you with some of the background of this program, but also specifically about two main outputs from this program, the guidance publication and the REWAS tool. And this has been a team effort, so from my colleagues Vera Hollander and Peter Drogers, they also contributed to this video. And just a short background on where this REWAS has been coming from. It all initiated with some discussions that we had with the FAO and external consultants, experts in the irrigation world, and looking at what kind of solutions are we finding these days to the global water problems. And a lot of the different solutions that are talking about water savings is actually focused on really improving irrigation efficiency or improving the efficient water use by crops, so more crop per drop. These are all centered around high-tech irrigation water savings technologies, which looks great. However, still today we're seeing quite some issues with with water problems, and these are just some headlines that we see quite regularly on the global water crisis, water shortage, different countries or regions enduring droughts, agricultural areas not being able to have enough water for their crop. So we are far from having solved the water problem. And this made us think of like what's in our approach should we adapt to be more effective with finding solutions. The REWAS was initiated from the thoughts from one very important FAO publication. Here is a screenshot of the front cover. It's called Does Improved Irrigation Technology Actually Save Water? And one quote from this publication talks about how high-tech irrigation in the absence of controlled water allocations might actually worsen the situation. So when you introduce high-tech irrigation such as drip irrigation, if it's not been managed or controlled well, it might actually lead to more consumption or expansion of area because farmers will tend to pump more water and then get a return for their investment. So this makes us question like, okay, so are we actually improving the situation if we introduce high-tech irrigation, and how can we find a way to introduce these innovations and also find other methods for actually achieving real water savings. What's is described quite well in this publication and also in this video that is available on YouTube is called the Jevons paradox, where this is probably the scenario that we want to be in, so wishful thinking, where we think if we have a higher efficiency in irrigation, that will have lower consumption. However, the hardcore reality might be that with a higher efficiency, we're going towards a scenario with higher consumption. And this may be one of the factors of why the water issues are not being resolved by introducing high-tech irrigation. So to look at a more wider aspect, we wanted to see like what are water savings achieved in agriculture and how do we translate this to what we call real water savings. And this picture, this diagram that I'll talk you through really clearly pictures what we've been doing previously. So traditionally, when we look at water savings, we might be looking only at the amount of irrigation that we're applying to the field. So that's also what is referred to when in these articles we're talking about improving irrigation efficiency. They're just talking about improving the amount of water applied to the field and how you can get the most crops produced from this amount of water. But of course, every field will actually have some water that goes off the field through surface runoff, and this water may be going to another field downstream of the area. There's also flows that go to groundwater, and that also might be feeding another field with irrigation water. So these two fields depend on the previous field in their irrigation. And that's how there's a whole system and network of different fields connected with each other. And any changes that are applied here in this yellow circle in changing the irrigation will actually affect any of the downstream users who depend on them. So that's why it's, in the real water savings, we're taking a look at what's happening at field scale, but also translating that to a perspective of a more basin system or basin scale, so having a larger perspective on this. So the main objective of REWAS is to quickly assess what's happening at field scale in any crop water interventions being introduced, and evaluating what would be the effect at system scale. And to do this, we use a follow the water approach. And a lot of these concepts from follow the water is similar to what you've been learning in your MOOC with water accounting. So from the water that's being used or applied, part of it can be divided into consumptive use and another part in return flows. Of the consumptive use, part of it is beneficial. So the water that is transpired by crops and actually bring yield, crop yield, higher production, that's considered beneficial use. You also have non-beneficial use, such as transpiration by weeds or evaporation from the soil or evaporation from water. And then to quickly summarize what's happening with the return flows, that's again divided into parts, with recoverable return flows being water that goes back into a water system and is being pumped up or diverted by downstream users. And non-recoverable is the water that is returning but then going to a sink where the water cannot be used again, such as the sea or the salty lakes or polluted polluted water bodies. And what this REWAS, what we're looking at is real water savings are what is achieved in reductions in non-beneficial consumptive use and in non-recoverable return flows. So those are the two terms that we keep in mind to try and see how we can achieve real water savings. And to do this, as I mentioned, there are two outputs that are available for you to look at, and I'll just give a short overview of what is reflected in these two different components. The first one is the guidance publication, and this gives a summary of field interventions that are focused on improving water productivity. So this guidance publication is an FAO publication, FAO Water Reports number 46. At the end of this presentation, I have a slide with the different links where you can find the data, the information. This publication gives a nice summary of the follow the water concepts and the similar to the water accounting approaches that you're learning in this MOOC. In addition, it gives a very nice literature review of over 240 different publications that are focused on different field interventions that are available for improving water productivity. And the field interventions, we make an inventory of these. We divided them up in three different themes: water theme, soil and land, and agronomy. And these are again divided into different categories and then different interventions. So it's in this guidance publication, an intervention can be described on converting to drip irrigation or different irrigation management, but it also looks at agronomic practices such as crop rotation or different crop varieties and the selection of that. And putting these all next to each other, it really looks at what kind of impact does this have on irrigation applied, evapotranspiration, and also specifically on water productivity. So it gives some guidance on helping decision makers see what are alternative interventions that also achieve improvements in water productivity and a higher yield. And at the end, there's some practical guidance on implementing these interventions and also an interesting link to the REWAS tool, which I'll talk about to you right now. So that's the second component of the REWAS program. The REWAS tool is a new tool that was developed in the in this program that Future World and FEO did together. And of course, there's the question, why do we develop a new tool? Well, looking at the different tools that are available at spatial scale, we have different models available at field scale and also ones that are available at hydrologic scales and basin scale. But we're really missing something that connects the field scale properly with a more system or basin scale aspect. And the same goes with high and low physical detail, looking at how much input data is needed there. There's also a gap, and it's we specifically developed REWAS to have very low physical detail, so that's very easy to use. It doesn't have a lot of equations involved, but and it's also all accessible for Excel, which is very familiar to most people. So it's easy to use, and the reason for that is that we really aim for REWAS to be used by decision makers so that they can easily compare different scenarios. So as I said, there's a gap between evaluating what's happening at field scale and evaluating what's happening at basin scale, where we have different models available, and REWAS is able to bridge this gap in between. So this is a screenshot of how the REWAS tool looks like. As I mentioned, it's an Excel tool, it's a macro-enabled Excel tool, so it has some nice interactiveness with it as well. And to run you through what you can see in the Excel tool, you have on one side the input data that you can enter. You have results available at field scale on what's happening with the different follow the water components at field scale, but also the water productivity values and any apparent water savings, which we consider any reductions in irrigation amounts. But also evaluation of what's happening at system scale, what are real water savings that are being achieved. So these numbers are available in comparing different alternative scenarios with a reference scenario. The same goes for a nice figures. We look at the water balance and the follow the water schematics. And one nice bonus of the REWAS tools also that aside of manually inputting data, you can also import simulation outputs from AgriPop. And these days we also developed a new option of inputting data from SWAP, so the SWAP model. So that makes it easy if you have some simulation model data available where you compare different scenarios that you can use, easily enter the data. And to give you an idea of how REWAS works and how it's very practical in its use, I want to talk you through one water savings example that we have from Nepal. It's an interesting article provided on change in irrigation in a study area in Nepal. So it looks at changing the irrigation method from furrow irrigation to drip irrigation. And it mentions in that paper that through this intervention, the water that was saved was 73%, which is quite impressive. But as we noticed before, traditionally we look at water savings by reductions of irrigation. So what we did in the REWAS study is look at the different numbers and see what are the real water savings, so what is actually being saved in water and not just reductions in irrigation amounts. So the claim was that 73% was saved in irrigation water. When we put it into a REWAS, we enter all the different input data that was mentioned in the article, looked at how much return flow was being recovered, and at the end, the result shows that the percentage of real water savings was only 6%, which still shows that there is quite some water savings being achieved. It's as a positive note that you can get a water savings of 6%. But the important message that we have here is if we would have reallocated the water based on the 73% of water savings, we would be over allocating water. So we would be allocating water that we're not actually saving because it's still in the system and still being used elsewhere. So that's why we find it important that we look at the numbers of 6%, which are the real water savings when looking at how can we allocate water differently. And that gives a nice idea of what you can do with REWAS. We have several other examples available as well that we've been developing together with several partners in different countries. If you are interested to know more on this project, I added the project website here that shows the training program that we're running right now. Also a link to the guidance publication where you can download it. It's openly accessible. And there are Moodle training courses available. There's a guest access where you can see which REWAS training course is running at that moment. But those are available on Future Water. But another nice thing for you to know is that this topic is also coming soon on the Open FAO eLearning Academy. So that's a self-paced course, and we expect that to be launched somewhere at the end of this year in 2022. So yeah, keep your eye on any new developments on that. And I want to thank you for listening to this video. If you have any questions, you can always email me. You can find me on or any of my colleagues on the project website as well.